Welcome back to my channel. So I'm still fighting a little cough and don't mind my lips. This is not blood or anything. This is actually, since I did a video yesterday, I did a red lipstick and my lips have been a little bit, you know, dry because obviously I've been sick and I feel like everything has been super dry. So ignore that. I promise it's not blood. But anyways, now that we've mentioned that, because I'm pretty sure you guys will be wondering, today I'm going to be doing a eyeshadow tutorial inspired by Mina from Sing 2 and Sing 1. I love those movies, you guys, so much. I'm such a huge, like, cartoon Disney movie person, and every time these movies come out, me and my husband are always in the movies. Actually, fun fact about us, you guys, we always go to the movies. Like, literally, that is like our date night. We love it. We love buying popcorn. We love just watching, you know, movies. So we are there all the time. So anyways, on Sing 2, I noticed Mina's eyeshadow. I actually noticed a lot of like the characters' eyeshadows, even though they are like animated. Like, I just think it's so cute when they add like makeup and all that stuff on them, but I should have done this. But so I took a screenshot of Mina's eyeshadow in that movie, and you guys, I am just obsessed with the colors. You guys, if you've been here for a while, you know that I love purples and like blues. And so when I saw this in the movie theater, I was like, why am I so inspired by this? I'm inspired by a cartoon in a movie, in an animated movie, and I just was really, really inspired that I just had to take a screenshot. With that said, super long intro, I do apologize. Remember, timestamps are always down below for you guys if you ever want to skip my intros. So with that said, I love you, and let's go ahead and begin. All right, guys, so I brought you in a little bit closer. I'm gonna go into this palette, and it's from Kara Beauty. I really, really enjoy Kara Beauty eyeshadows. I feel like they're super pigmented and they are priced at a very good price point. So I want to go into a dark blue first, and this one's called Stroke of Midnight. So I'm going to go into this eyeshadow right there. So I'm going to go into my Morphe M506. All right, guys, so I'm just going to start to apply it like just right in my crease. I don't want to take this blue up too high because I really want just the purple to be the star of the show, and then the main lid glittery shade that I want to use for this look. So just felt super inspired by her look, and the movie was so cute. The reason why I actually really enjoy watching that movie is because it really gives you positive like motivation, like positive vibes and motivation for like to reach your goals and your dreams. It's crazy how a movie, Disney movies overall, I feel like really give you that boost of confidence, you know what I mean? Anybody else think that? Like when he was saying about like achieving your dreams and not giving up.
You know what's great about hitting rock bottom? There's only one way left to go, and that's up.
In that movie, like I was just like, oh my god, like it just inspires you. But anyways, this pigment though, crazy, right? I love Kara Beauty eyeshadows. They're super, super pigmented. So I'm gonna go ahead and place this, and then we will buff this out with another brush. I think I'm gonna go into my Morphe M433. Yep. So it's clean, it has no product, and I'm just going to buff out the harsh lines. Whenever I do this, I just feel like it's easier for me to add the second eyeshadow, which would be the purple one. Instead of going in right away with the second shade, I feel like it takes longer to blend. So I always kind of like to prep it, and then I will go into that purple shade. All right, guys, so I started to go into the shade called Therapy Sesh from the Jaclyn Hill Volume 2 palette with Morphe. And I'm still taking that Morphe M506 brush, and I'm just pretty much applying it right above that blue shade, and I'm just moving it back and forth. I think I might go in with like a pinky shade above the purple one, because I feel like it looks like the picture looks more pinky. I kind of want to add like a pink to the really bring out that purple out. But for right now, I'm just going to go into Therapy Sesh. I'm just going to buff this in and out. And then I'm going to go into another clean Morphe M433 brush with no product, and I just started to just kind of buff this out. So now with that clean Morphe M433, you guys, I'm gonna go into Tipsy Girl from that Jaclyn Hill palette. And what I'm doing is just going right on top of that purple shade that we used. And I feel like this is gonna make it a little bit better. And then I am gonna go back into that purple shade and just kind of go back in with my M506 from Morphe, and I'm just going to apply it again so that way we don't lose this shade. And the blue, I mean, it's already really prominent, so I don't want to add too much. I just pretty much just want to go in with the purples and the pinks. All right, you guys, so I did this eye off camera because I kind of wanted to make sure that the colors were kind of looking like Mina's, and I think I got it. So I'm gonna go into that Stroke of Midnight palette again from Kara Beauty. Remember, we used it for that dark brown, that dark blue shade. So I love this color here called Dreaming, and I wanted to use this as the eyeshadow base. It's not as glittery as I want, but I do have another palette here that is more like, there's like the same color as this eyeshadow, but it's like chunkier glitter. But we're gonna go into that one first as our base. So with absolutely no setting spray or anything, I'm going into my MAC 239S brush. And what I'm doing is just gonna build up this color and apply it all over the lid. Of course, you can go in and apply glitter adhesive, whatever you do to apply your loose glitters, but I'm just gonna go in dry. Try your best to not cover up the blue. Like, you still wanna see it just a little bit of that little darkness, because she has a little bit of darkness like around her eyeshadow. So I am just going to take it up as much as I want, but try your best just not cover up that blue. And then, you guys, I'm gonna go into my MAC Morphe M506 with no product. I'm just going to buff this out just so that everything looks nice and smooth. All right, and now I'm gonna go into this Beauty Creations palette. I got this last year. This is their Remy, hopefully I'm saying that right, Circus Clown eyeshadow palette. And look at this eyeshadow palette. It is so colorful, beautiful. I also love Beauty Creations eyeshadows, especially this shade right here. So you guys can see it is super glittery compared to the first one that we went in, the shade right here. And you can tell right away, like, it just gives it like a little boost. And that's definitely what I needed, because I was only gonna go into just this eyeshadow, but I just felt like there was something missing, you know, and I feel like I found it. Because you can tell right away, it just looks more bold and vibrant. I'm still using that same brush, and because this eyeshadow is super glittery, but it still feels wet and creamy, so I don't have to go into any glitter adhesive, but you guys are more than welcome to. I just applied it right on top of this eyeshadow, and you can tell it just gives it a little boost. So going back into my M506, I'm just going to go in with no product just to blend this out so that way everything looks nice and smooth. So in Mina's picture, she does seem to have like a little bit of eyeliner, but just on top of the lash line. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that, but I'm gonna grab a gel liner. I don't see a wing or anything like that, so I'm gonna try my best to just keep it very close to my lash line. I'm gonna go into the Maybelline Long Lasting Drama Gel Liner, and then I'm gonna go into my Morphe M508 brush, and I'm just going to run this on the top, on my top lash line, which is great because once we go in with lashes, we won't see any skin peeking through. I'm gonna bring it in towards the inner corner and then just kind of run it towards the waterline, like we're tide lining. I'm gonna go back into that dark blue shade that we used at the very, very beginning, and I'm just going to pat it right on top of that black. All right, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and clean this off, finish the rest of my face, and then I'm gonna apply some lashes and be right back with you guys to finish off the eyes, mostly just the under eye, and then we are almost complete with this look, so I will be right back. All right, guys, so for my under eye, I'm gonna go in it to the Beauty Creations. This is their Dare to Be Bright gel pencil, and it's just black pretty much. So I'm gonna run this just in my waterline, and then I am going to apply this, take it a little bit down towards the lash line, the lower lash line, into my lashes. Taking my Morphe times Ariel small little brush, I'm gonna go back into that purple shade from the Jaclyn Hill Volume 2 palette, and I'm just gonna run this towards my lower lash line, right on top of that black pencil. And then for mascara, I'm gonna go into my Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara, and I'm going to just coat my bottom lashes. And then, you guys, I'm gonna go ahead and do my brows off camera, apply some lip, and then remove the remaining powder that I have on my under eye. And then we are going to complete this look. All right, you guys, and that is it for today's eyeshadow tutorial inspired by Mina from Sing 2. What do you guys think? What are your thoughts? Did I nail it? Let me know. I don't know why I felt so inspired by Mina. I love eyeshadow. You guys already know that I love to play with some eyeshadows. And I just felt so inspired by her after watching the movie. So if you guys felt inspired as well, please tag me on Instagram because you know that I love to see your recreations. I don't know yet if I'm going to be adding any fake freckles. If I do, if I end up liking it last minute, then I will add them and then I will show them to you guys on Instagram. So definitely follow me there. I will post a picture if I decided to do the freckles. As always, I will list all the products, all the palettes that I did use today on this eyeshadow look down below in that description box. So please check that out. If I do forget anything, please let me know. And I will definitely, you know, reply back to you guys if I forget anything, because sometimes I can be very forgetful. So I love you. Thank you for the constant love and support. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel before you do leave today, and I will see you guys on Saturday para un video en español. Besitos, los quiero, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.